There was nothing but dead skin all over that, like, bed. I was like, oh, Jesus Christ. And that kind of relates now to, I mean, it was a little bit better than the first time I ever fucked a stripper. Has anyone here ever had, like, the ability, or, like, the true honor of, like, pulling a stripper from a strip club? It's a total thick...
Bite her hair and she pissed me off.
Oh, shit. All right. No, but there was a time I went to a strip club back in West Virginia where I'm from, and it was cool because when I got the chick, I was like, what can I do with you? You know, normally I'm not allowed to touch. And she said, you can do whatever you want to me. And so I did. And then, like, when it ended, I got her number and stuff, and I managed to coax her back to my apartment and everything. And the first thing was, she was like, first of all, I'm going through a divorce right now, so we're not going to fuck. That just turned out to be a lie, because about 5 minutes later, we went at it. And, I mean, she must have been right, too, about, like, not getting laid for a year or whatever, because it was, like, way tight. And then the next morning when I woke up, I'm so glad I didn't black out and she was there, because it looked like Jeffrey Dahmer or somebody had, like, done a sling. There was blood all over those fucking sheets, man. Right, I mean, no, I mean, I appreciated that better than the fucking dead skin cells. I mean, hell, I washed those sheets right away, the blood. I'm like, man, that's an accomplishment. That's a stripper. Those are war stains right there. I'll keep that for a week. Okay. Yeah, I know, man. No, you're getting to know me really well, Casey. And hell, that smoke. I think I'll go ahead and finish you up with... this one here. We're all in Sacramento, so I know that you've the craziness you're probably able to witness. With my job, we have to repair fences and do things like that. So outside, this is totally ironic, outside of a gated community, there is a broken gate. So our job is to show up there and just repair this thing. But outside of the gate, there's a dude just walking back and forth, having a bad meth tweet going... just strolling back and forth of this thing, and like, we're looking at the security station, like, where is the security to come out here and remove this dude? And we thought like something crazy was going to happen, because one of the people at the home, like, community thing walks out, they have a conversation with the meth tweaker, and they walk on. So when we pull up, we go over to the dude, and they're like, hey, do you want to call security or someone to get him out of here? Because we got to repair that fence. And the dude looked at us without batting an eye. He said, oh no, that's the security. Like, for real. No, like, I mean, I guess, you know, fuck it. $150, you know, whatever, a week to pay the security guy $20 worth of meth, good to go. And, I mean, the security was good, too, because the next person that showed up that they didn't recognize, bah, leveled them right out. Hey, man, that's good. You get what you pay for, you know what I mean? With that, I'll go ahead and give it back to your host here, and I'll retire my fancy... futuristic Blade Runner, what you call.
I got it.
All right, thank you. I'm Chris for Red Sound, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for having me.
Woo!
Stay away from the junior highs. Same. I'm going to catch you with Jolly Ranchers in your pocket. For no reason. So, we were going to have... Hold on just a second. We were going to have you come up, but Holly wants to play a song really fast. Sorry, she outdoes you. She's sorry. Sorry, dude. So let's hear it again for Chris. I almost said Larry again. So, you know, you were talking about the guy's out there, he's helping me fix the brake light, and the security guard pulls up, and the guy starts laughing, right? And I'm like, well, what's so funny? He goes, that's our security guard. I go, so he's funny? He goes, no, yesterday he comes running in the store, and he's like, somebody, please help me, help me. And we're asking him, well, what's wrong? Someone stole the light off the top of my car. They're like, well, where were you? He was in the car, tick-a-talking. Like, that's great security right there. You're in the car, someone steals the light. I'm like, I can just see that now. Someone's gonna be pulling up in the driveway right now with the lights from the top bumping with their bass.
Yeah.
Some security lights. Are you ready? Ready? Here they go.
Go ahead.
I'm
We don't have crime.
Go ahead!
2, 3
Go ahead.
Can I play the four?